And the Pink Floyd's tortured genius Syd Barrett dies as he lived a recluse. Now, Syd Barrett, one of the founding members of the Pink Floyd, has died at the age of 60. Syd's disappearance from the band provoked all kinds of strange rumours, though the truth was rather sadder than the weird theories surrounding him. Robin Denslow reports.
It was one of the most extraordinary stories of the rock era. Syd Barrett was a musical legend, although he'd been a recluse for 30 years. Yet back in the 60s, he was arguably the key figure in that cult band of the psychedelic era, Pink Floyd.
He was absolutely vital. He was the person that you would look at because he was the singer and the guitar player, as you say, but he was also, more important, he wrote all the original songs. He was the person who initially wrote all the original songs, which was very, very important because otherwise they were playing sort of blues standards with strange instrumentals in the middle of them.
Pink Floyd had started out as a Cambridge blues band named after two bluesmen, but by the time they'd become the house band in that legendary London club UFO, the music had changed totally. The band played in half darkness, hidden behind a then novelty, a light show. Joe Boyd ran UFO.
Well, I don't think we would have started the UFO Club if it hadn't been for Pink Floyd and Syd Barrett, because they were getting popular with the kind of people we knew would come to something like this. And the fact that they were going to be our house band meant that we knew we were going to get an audience.
Well, yes, it's sort of the...
Even when the Pink Floyd moved on to concert halls, the shows were unique. Peter Jenner remembers how the band, with their lead guitarist and singer Syd Barrett, were banned from the Queen Elizabeth Hall after covering it in Daffodils.
And because, you know, it's a very psychedelic thing to do, and flower power and all that stuff. And it, not in a malicious way, but the Daffodils got walked into the ground and onto the leather seats, and shock horror. And there were no more rock concerts for some time.
New
there.
Band.
The first Pink Floyd single, Arnold Lane, written, of course, by Syd Barrett, was predictably controversial and banned by the BBC. It was produced by Joe Boyd.
They were great guys to work with. We did it all in 2 days and sold it to EMI Records. And
it was a hit?
It was a hit. Well, it was banned by the BBC.
Dodgy lyrics.
Yeah, panty sniffer.
Pink Floyd were poised to move on and become a major band. But as their success grew, there were stories of excessive drug-taking, and Syd Barrett was clearly becoming ill. His behaviour was increasingly erratic.
You add in a dose of acid, and as far as I gather, lots of doses of acid, plus suddenly going from just being a bloke to being a star, to, you know, to touring America, to having people asking you the meaning of life, it all gets pretty confusing. And having then the business leaning on him, you know, whether it was me or whether it was the record company, write more songs, write the new single, you know, there was a lot of pressure. And I think what had been fun suddenly became an awful lot of trouble and tribulation.
Yes, I'm thin.
Syd Barrett left Pink Floyd in 1968, but there was no ill feeling. The band helped him with solo projects, but now they began to live very different lives. Syd became a recluse, hidden away for literally decades in his mum's house in Cambridge, where he died, while the new Pink Floyd became household names across the world, while help keeping Syd Barrett's name alive through songs like Wish You Were Here and Shine On, You Crazy Diamond.
I think there's still a tremendous influence of Syd's sensibility on all the songs that Roger wrote and Dave Gilmour wrote. There's still something, a sound today that you hear in the Floyd that I recognize from the Floyd that I used to hear at UFO.
Syd Barrett, the Crazy Diamond.